In a previous screencast, we went through the following problem using a guess and check iterative method. So the first thing we did was we took our energy equation shown here, and then we wrote down all of our knowns, converted them to the appropriate units, and then simplified our energy equation. So at that point, once we plugged everything in, we got our energy balance down to a very simplified form that just had the friction factor F and our diameter D. So this was a guess and check iterative method. What I want to show you here now is how we could do this analytically in a computer solver-based program. Now, the Moody diagram is based on empirical evidence, lots of experiments. It's someone, specifically Colebrook, came around and said, hey, there's probably a good relationship here, and came up with an empirical equation that matched the non-laminar range of the Moody diagram. So this relationship is here, which is a function of the Reynolds number, the relative roughness, and the friction factor F. So again, using this kind of equation, you solve for one of the variables given the other two. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to rearrange this equation and set it equal to zero. So it looks like the following. Now if we simplify this so it's only a function of the diameter D and the friction factor F, using values we already had before, we could get rid of epsilon. We could also get rid of the Reynolds number. So now we have a relationship between F and D, based on the Colebrook equation here. And we could take this in conjunction with our energy equation, which also was a function of F and D. And if you recall, our energy equation looked like the following. So what do we do at this point? Well, let's rewrite the energy equation to solve for F. So now we have a relationship for F. We have a relationship between D and F that must be equal to zero. We're missing one last thing. Set D, our diameter. Right? So this follows the same train of thought we had last time. Choose a D. This gives us F. Using that F and that D, does it solve this equation? So this is where Excel comes in handy. We only need three cells. We'll have a cell for the diameter, a cell for the friction factor, and lastly, our Colebrook equation. So here, let's just put in a diameter. Here we have to type in our expression for our friction factor. Lastly, we enter in our Colebrook equation. So we have our three cells that we need. We know the Colebrook equation has to be equal to zero. So we go to data, what if analysis, and goal seek. And it may be different depending on the version of Excel you're using. We want to set this to zero. And we want to do that by changing the diameter. So you could also use solver to do this. Goal seek's pretty quick. We get a value of 0.409. If you recall in the last screencast, based on guessing and checking, we said 0.41 was pretty close. So when we convert this in terms of inches, we get 4.912 inches for our diameter. So although it may be not worth custom making a pipe to meet that specification, it's a good starting point to do some analysis to see if we could use a 5-inch pipe. So hopefully this gives you an idea on how to set up the iterative approach in Excel and quickly solve for this without doing a guess and check method.